You created this venture in 2015, and the initial pact was to remain together for 5 years. Why is the JV now ending early?
Well, I think both partners are clearly comfortable with the transaction that we announced today. Saudi Aramco in the last 2.5 years had deep insights in the world of synthetic rubber. They would like to accelerate further and invest in technology and further capacities. This is, of course, something that doesn't fit with our strategy, and for that reason, we came together in the last 2 months, have negotiated intensively, also over the weekends, and finalized contracts over the last 2 days, and went out both with a smile on our face, because we think it's a win for Aramco, it's a win for Lanxess, it's a win for Lanxess, so everybody is happy.
But give me a sense, how is it working with Saudi Aramco? Did you achieve what you expected? Was it easier than thought? Was it more difficult than you expected?
Well, I think Saudi Aramco is a prime partner. It's the biggest oil and gas company in the world with top-notch experts in the industries they operate in. And I'm sure that in a few years down the road, Aramco is going to be the number one also in downstream, especially as far as synthetic rubber is concerned. So they will definitely be a prime owner for synthetic rubber business.
Matthias, wonderful to have you with us today. What I find interesting is the new smaller company within the multinationals of Germany and continental Europe. What is your strategy forward in terms of growing revenues? Are you going to acquire to grow, or can you grow organically?
Well, we've clearly stated that we are an active participant in the industry consolidation, but we want to be in specialty chemicals in small and mid-sized markets. So wherever we compete, we want to be a leader internationally, globally. And through the three acquisitions we've done over the last 1.5 years, I think you can see that we are an active participant in the industry consolidation.
You know, you worked with Aventis, you worked with Mercedes-Benz, you came up through the financial channel. Is smaller corporations within Europe, are they becoming more Anglo-American in style, or can there be something uniquely German about your next strategic 10 years?
Well, I've always been a fan of operational excellence, and whilst I have a lot of sympathy for the financial analysis, I'm always striving for operational connectivity, and I love the chemical industry, and therefore what I'm doing here is fun, and I think you will see that Lanxess is going to make big strides going forward.
Now that you're out of the rubber business and you're more into the specialty chemicals, Mr. Zachert, are you 100% sure that's the right direction? There's a lot of money in rubber.
Well, if you see what we have done over the last few years, we have consolidated the industry with appropriate multiples, which was valued highly by shareholders. So this journey is going to continue. We will not rush into transactions. We will do transactions when the time has come from a strategic standpoint and from a financial attractiveness. And therefore, no need to hurry. We are patient and look forward to a interesting dynamic industry.
With the proceeds, would you be looking at another acquisition? Is there anything out there on the horizon that you'd like to own?
Well, I would first of all like to mention that we had, after the Chemtura acquisition, around about 2.5, 2.6 net financial debts that we had on our balance sheet. So after receiving the proceeds for the divestiture of rubber, we will be in a very, very solid investment-grade position that offers us opportunity for organic, but also in the future for inorganic growth.